This video is once again sponsored by Lord of Heroes. Lord of Heroes is a free-to-play mobile animation RPG with beautiful 3D anime graphics and spectacular effects. It has almost 15 knights with various characteristics and it has no character gacha, so you can recruit any character with 100% chance. Every character can be upgraded up to 6 stars maximum. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below for you guys to check it out. The game has recently released some new updates. It now has a hard story open called Light and Darkness, new characters named Solfi, a brilliant arcade whose greatest goal in life is the acquisition of all knowledge, and Baretta, a clumsy assassin who loves betting more than anything else. The game also has new hero contracts for Nine, Baretta, and Solfi, new content called Obelix, located in between Dokkaeon and Gao's Empire, which you can unlock after completing the story from Region 8 till 16 on Hearth, and new alchemy system which guarantees a hero alchemy contract. You can now obtain a selected hero's artifact with 100% chance. One artifact is guaranteed with a hero of your choosing, and each alchemy requires 2,000 crystals. Alchemy can be used 3 times per month, and the timer resets every first of the month at midnight local time. Once again, if you guys would like to try this game out yourself, you can click the link in the description box below to download it. Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm going to give you some of my personal tips on how to keep your bedroom tidy at all times. Keep in mind that these are some tips to maintain the cleanliness and to keep your room from getting cluttered. This is not a guide on how to do a deep cleaning of a super messy bedroom. Just putting that disclaimer there before anyone says things like,
"Oh my god, your room is already clean! Why did you even bother making a video about room cleaning? Useless! Unsubscribe!"
By the way, if you guys think that I look kinda tired, it's because I am tired. Tip number 1. Keep cleaning supplies nearby. Having to look for cleaning supplies whenever you want to do some quick cleaning will most likely make you feel too lazy to start tidying up. So make sure to keep them handy in a place where you can easily reach for them in your room every time you want to clean something. I keep my cleaning supplies in a container underneath my console table. That way, every time I need to do some quick cleaning like wiping my desk, bookcase, and other surfaces, I can just grab my microfiber cloth and all-purpose cleaning spray and just wipe away. Don't think about it, just do it. The more time you spend thinking about having to clean, the more it makes you not want to clean. Act like a robot and do things immediately without thinking about it too much. Don't give your brain a chance to change your mind and postpone things. For example, when you wake up in the morning and you're still half asleep, just move mechanically and make your bed without dreading about it beforehand. Basically, if you can finish it in 5 minutes or less, then don't postpone it. This is a motto that my mom would tell me ever since I was a kid. Sometimes a simple task of tidying up would only take less than 5 minutes, but we would procrastinate for days because we thought it would take a long time to finish. But once we do it, we realize, hey, it took me only 5 minutes to wipe my desk and put everything back in place. Why didn't I do it sooner? My gosh, I really need to cut my fringe, it's so long. The sooner you do it, the less work you'll have to do later, so don't postpone something that you can finish in 5 minutes or less. If you find it hard to start, try counting down from 5. There are times when I just feel too lazy to get up from bed and make the bed. One trick I like using is to do a countdown. I would tell myself, okay, I'm gonna count down from 5, and as soon as I reach 0, I will get up and make my bed in 20 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! I find that giving myself a limited time to do something will make me more motivated to get it out of the way as soon as possible. Put everything back in place once you've finished using it. Don't let them scatter all over your room. It's gonna be a bother to tidy them up later on. And before you know it, they'll pile up and you'll spend more time doing a deep cleaning when you could have actually saved yourself all that trouble if only you had put everything back in place as soon as possible. Don't leave your room empty-handed. When you want to go out of your room, take a look around and see if there's anything you can bring with you outside. Maybe there's an empty cup lying on your desk. You can take it with you as you're heading to the kitchen. Or maybe you're going to take a shower and you spot some dirty laundries lying around on the floor. Take them with you and put them in the laundry basket in the restroom. That way, you'll be killing 2 birds with 1 stone. Make use of loading time. For example, when you're playing a game on your phone or on your console, there would be some loading time or downtime. Instead of staring at your screen like a dum-dum, you can use the spare time to do quick tasks like putting items back to their places, wiping your bedside table, cleaning your mirror, etc. That way, you don't need to dedicate a huge chunk of your time just to clean up everything, because you've already tidied things up little by little during every downtime. Don't hang on to garbage. Throw out old receipts, tissue papers, junk mails, and all those stuffs immediately. If you wish to keep some of your old receipts or movie tickets because you find them memorable, you can try gluing them in your notebook. Doing so will keep the small garbage from piling up and keep your room free from clutter. Clean up before going to bed. I don't know about you guys, but for me, it doesn't feel very pleasant to wake up to a messy bedroom. So before going to bed, I would spend a few minutes cleaning up here and there. Maybe you have some clutters lying around that you forgot to tidy up during the day. Put them away quickly before going to bed. That way, you wake up to a nice clean bedroom the next day. Okay, so those were some of the tips that I could share with you guys. I hope you found them helpful. By the way, I've recently started streaming on Twitch, so if you guys would like to follow me there, it's at twitch.tv/RaffiRaffi. And no, I didn't take a break from posting on YouTube because I started streaming on Twitch. They don't really have any correlation between them. Twitch is basically just me playing video games while talking for a few hours. So yeah, it's completely different from making YouTube videos. If you ever decide to stop by and watch me stream, please remember to read the rules beforehand. Anyway, that's all from me today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. And I will see you guys in my next video. Have a nice day, everyone. Bye-bye.